Welcome to Powered by Podio. Automation is everything. Supercharge your business with Podio. Get ready for another episode of Supercharged with Jordan Samuel Fleming, your weekly dive into the awesome impact workflow and automation can have on your business when it's powered by Podio. Join us each week as we learn from the top Podio partners in the world, as we investigate system integrations and add-ons, and hear from real business owners who have implemented Podio into their business. Now, join your host, Jordan Samuel Fleming, CEO of Game Changers, for this week's episode.
Hey, everybody, and welcome to this week's episode of Supercharged. I'm your host, Jordan Samuel Fleming, here to talk all about the power of workflow and automation when your business is powered by Podio. Now, today's episode, I welcome back an old friend of mine, Seth Helgeson, CEO of Tech Ego, as well as thatapp.io. Really, someone who is a data scientist and really understands the fundamentals about good database interaction, of good database creation management, and about how systems should work in your business. And we really focus our conversation on one of his products, Sync, which is a backup tool on the face of things. It's a way of backing up your Podio organization, your files, your comments, your workspaces, apps, all of those things. But it's a lot more than that as well. And we dive into a little bit about how Sync is really a tool that lets you play your data out and use it in other instances. There's a lot of technical jargon that I can't even pretend I understand around, you know, Mongo databases and all these sorts of things. But at the heart of it, we focus in on how, of course, Sync is there to back up your Podio, to take your data out, and to give you opportunities to use that data. And that's a really fantastic part of the tool. I do recommend clicking on the link, taking a look at Sync. It's a very easy process to log in and sync via your Podio and get everything backed up. And of course, with his file vault edition, every single one of those files that you've got uploaded into Podio is there as well. Check him out, fantastic opportunity. He and I catch up on a number of things around Podio and structures and life itself, as we're both woodworkers and fans of barbecues. It's a great chance to catch up for he and I, but also a way of bringing you guys a bit of insight into how his tool Sync can really get your data moving inside and outside of Podio. So let's dive right in.
So I'll cut out the woodworking bits, but I'm really keen to really talk about, I want to understand about Sync. I want to understand about, obviously from a Podio layman's point of view, why Sync is going to bring them something good. Why, you know, let's really kind of dig into this. I've just started to use it. I don't know that much about it. Give us, you know, let's start the ball rolling with what the hell is Sync.
Yeah. So, well, Sync, I started out Sync with Sync, geez, back in 2013, it started a backup for Podio, and it was MySQL, basically rebuilding a MySQL database for Podio. And it was just, it was so laborious with trying to get all this data to fit into one system. And with that, we decided, you know, after one revision, multiple other revisions, we said, okay, we actually need a big data database. And it was back when MongoDB actually launched, and we started looking at these big data, went to a couple conferences, and we said, okay, this is definitely the way we need to start storing things. And so back then it used to be where people could just back up the data and then hold it in a snapshot, right? And just and basically download a snapshot once a day or once a week or whatever, and just take a rolling snapshot once a day or whatever they set it as, once a day, once a week, once a month. But then we said, you know, we can actually get this to be live given how fast MongoDB can actually take this data. So let's go ahead and install webhooks on every single app and workspace and org, and literally, as they fire, as data comes in, we just store it. We just take the JSON array, and we just store all that data into the MongoDB database. So each client gets a MongoDB database that is completely encrypted and secured. And then they're able to, you know, back up all their orgs or back up an org for about $1 a day.
So just because there's a lot of people who won't understand what MongoDB is, and I don't want to get into the technical weeds here, mm-hmm. but really from a, you know, we always hear backup solutions, you know, like backs up once a day, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. Really one of the core differentiators that I see here, and one of the things that maybe Mongo allows you to do, but that's not the, it doesn't really matter about the Mongo part, except for the fact that it allows you to do it, is this ability to, in real time, backup data. So a bit of data, I create a new item in Podio, mm-hmm. it's backed up.
Yep.
Right. And yep. so does that also mean if I accidentally delete it, I can restore it, or does it, by deleting it, do I delete it from the Mongo database?
Nope. It's it's all stored in the database. And so the second an item is updated or even created, created or updated, it's instantly in our system. As fast as Podio webhook can return it. So, but once we have that, yeah, if you delete that item, you can come right into the system and then find it and then restore it. But it wasn't enough for us just to build a sync, you know, the sync database of just saying, hey, here's your stuff and here's it all backed up. You had to put in the GDPR settings so that you can actually set how long you want to store deleted items from Podio, right? So it's up to 6 months. You can set that in, or you can just turn it off completely. And then there's other settings we wanted, is people actually being able to update items instead of sync. So if they actually go into an item and update it, it would update Podio. So the ability to restore, update, and then Podio with it going down occasionally, we started looking at it saying, you know, why don't we just start extending this to make this of, if Podio goes down, you can actually start working from your backup copy. And, you know, if the web goes down or something like that, then you're able to do that. And with the addition of our other products like Ava, we're now adding in other platforms. So you're going to be able to start to data bind or bind your data together from other systems and actually start backing up your data from other platforms as well.
And I mean, from a day-to-day usability point of view, I mean, I guess there's a couple things that people, use cases that people think of, you know, the most, but one of the things that you guys also back up is you back up the files as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yep. If I've got a Podio infrastructure where there is quite a lot of file elements being uploaded or managed or tracked, mm-hmm. All of those are safely secured as well.
Yeah. So every single file, every comment, every task, everything that Podio creates and does is 100% stored inside the system. All your files are actually encrypted as they are downloaded and stored in encrypted database as well. And at that point, we can restore files to systems as well. So our file haven is a part of sync. File haven allows you to, you know, back up all that data, but we're extending that this year to include being able to, you know, connect in your other, let's say, Microsoft OneDrive and set up file formats or, you know, folder formats. So that way, as your data is being backed up, it will actually create the folder structures you need and then place those files into the folders you want. So technically you won't need to have it stored on our system in the future, but depending on the right plan, which is really nice, and a lot of admins and business owners, even tech directors, we are able to give them database access with, you know, their higher plans, where they can then go into that data in the database and then they can start to use it and manage it more efficiently and actually bypass the Podio API, because they can actually pull data directly from the database instead of pulling it from Podio.
So you know, if, as I understand it, and I'm not the technical part of anything, but, you know, you've got the sort of what I would class as the lower end use case of it, which is just like, I want to make sure my Podio information is backed up. Like,
yep.
I want to make sure it's safe from a business continuity point of view. I've got to protect myself. And that yep. is bang. That is real time. It's not once a day. It's not, you know, it's not like, oh, by the way, your backup's here, but you're going to miss everything. But that was done after 9 a.m. this morning, exactly. You know, last morning when we did our last.
It's not in a backup. Google sheet. Yeah, it's not in a spreadsheet of somewhere.
So that's the core of core. But at a higher level, you're saying that there is a technical capability of your system, which gives you more, I would almost class as data, more database friendly tools to potentially extend. And I know we've done some bits about this where, you know, where inside of your system, we're grabbing a JSON feed, which is then giving us all the data we need, and we're not having to go anywhere else for it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And we wanted to extend Podio's functionality quite a bit better. The views that you have stored in Podio, they'll be available inside of our system as well. And even taking it a little bit further, that you can now create filters and pivot tables on our data interactions. So when you're actually looking through your data, you can start to pivot on that data, create pivot tables, you can load your save views, and actually be able to create your own save views with parameters that are not available inside of Podio. For example, is not selected, instead of, you know, and a bunch of others that are really frustrating in there. So in that respect, it's been a fun journey. You know, we've got a little bit of competition from Momentum Tools there, but we're seeing a big influx of users coming in that, you know, they bounce between. I mean, we've lost customers to them as well, but at the same time, it's just what customers are really looking for, right? It's two good fits out there that depends on what they want to be able to achieve with the systems.
Absolutely. And I mean, there's never, it's probably a good thing that there's, you know, there's an element of competition out there. I mean, you want other systems out there to be pushing you and to make sure that the market, you know, it shows that there's a market for the product in a big bad way.
Absolutely.
As well.
Yeah. A great product that they can get into Google Docs. That's in Google Sheets. That's, it's something that we just don't do. And so when customers do want that, it's a lot easier for us to say, instead of, oh, we'll build that for you, it's a lot easier to say, hey, you know, we recommend, you know, another system. But yeah, but it's been a fun journey, and we're excited for all the other things that we've got going on. We've got Iris that's a part of this system. Now that we have all of your data inside of your system, you're able to start tearing through. We have Audit, which allows you to audit and see who's making updates in your system across the platform, because you're not going to receive those notifications inside of Podio because you're not subscribed to it. But then you can audit transactions. You can audit who has access to workspaces and when they last received that data. And the beautiful part of it is when you do sync that, we also subscribe to the push notifications. So those push notifications are how your calculation fields are updated. So And in that sense, what's really critical is right now, if you go and do a backup, you know, chances are your calc fields are going to be wrong. And since there's so many, or they're going to be out of date, right, pretty quick. So when you go to do a next backup, it's again out of date. So every time an item is updated, we get the freshest copy of it. Sure. But if that item's not updated, but there's 15 calcs on that page that updated, we're catching those calcs and then putting it back into the JSON arrays.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
And how does that work with the poor performance of, you know, I mean, there's not a day that goes by where the Podio calc fields aren't just a joke in terms of display. Well, I mean, it's just like, oh my God. I mean, you know.
Well, one thing we found actually is that the calc fields will process faster because they're storing them, actually processing them on a different server. But the API has nothing to do with the calcs, but the interface is actually the slowest part. So the calculation fields will actually calculate faster than what the interface will show. And you can then get, when we get a push notification, it delivers the entire payload. So we don't have to go do a get item. It just says, okay, here's everything that was just updated. And since it sends us that payload, we'll get hammered with just, you know, thousands of calc updates. And we've had to whittle that down to, let's just batch those per customer, right? Let's just batch that, because, you know, somebody goes and updates, you know, 50,000 items or let's see, what's GlobiFlow capable of? Two items at once, right? Just kidding.
That's mean. Mean-spirited.
No, I'm joking. I'm sorry. It's only because
GlobiFlow anyway.
I know. Only, yeah, exactly. I was talking about the past. You know, it's in the past now. But when those items update, you know, we'll get, our system will get hit pretty hard. And then at that point, we just, that's where MongoDB and that big data database allows us to store massive amounts of transactions very, very rapidly. So it's been a really good setup. It's really smooth and allowing customers to, you know, ask for services that we haven't even thought of yet and start to build them into the system. And so big IT, IT directors and higher ups that are looking at data management, data security, right? If they ever decide to leave Podio, they can literally just take everything out and then we can push it to another platform. Or people that are leaving Salesforce, we can connect into Salesforce, back everything up, and then provision it into Podio, into a system that's already existing. So that sync, it used to be called backup for Podio, but we've now turned it to sync because, you know, that's really what we're doing.
It's a more accurate explanation. And well, that's, I mean, I'm not going to pretend I understand the big data bit and the Mongo bit, but as I don't, but I do, one of the things you've said there is, I think, really interesting, in that one of the things that I've been thinking deeper about, more deeper now than ever before, probably because I've been designing more things in smartphone and I've been thinking about other systems and I've been dreaming and kind of experimenting, is where things are good, where things should be allowed to shine versus trying to force something that doesn't fit. Mm-hmm. And Podio, I think, still, even now, even with its not stellar performance at times right now, Podio mm-hmm. still does some things as an out-of-the-box solution capability better than any system I know.
Oh, yeah.
But it can't do everything.
Yeah.
And so you, given that, when you understand that, you can think about Podio as, hey, this is what Podio is going to allow me to do. It's going to allow my team to easily manage a process and do this, this, and that, and automate this. Great. That's what Podio kills at. Mm-hmm. But then all of that data, that repository of information that you may want to use, you got to find, Podio ain't good at that bit. So yeah. That's where you've got to find something else to connect to. And it's always struck me as we've started to look more at your, you know, I mean, full disclosure, we have integrated sync into our platforms now from a game changes point of view, where we're migrating most of our support mm-hmm. contracts over there, mainly because of this extendability.
Yep.
It's not even the minute to minute, second by second backup is great, but most people's data is not that it's great, but it's like, it's so rarely a problem. But it's that ability to then pivot quickly and grab the data and do something else with it that exactly. I think is really what's very interesting about that. And now you've talked a bit about Iris. Can you mm-hmm. I obviously sync is the Podio of this, in that it can mm-hmm. it gets the data, in my opinion, right? It's the yep. it's the hub. But you've got these other bits around it. You've got Ava, you've got mm-hmm. print, you've got the Iris and mm-hmm. this. From an Iris point of view, what is that focused on? I'm just curious.
So we started out with Iris inside of Sync, because when we started working with Podio organizations to tear apart their business processes, we needed to be able to see a snapshot and a proof of concept of this is how bad or inner lack of connectivity your actual organization has with each other, right? And back in the day when Podio was just beginning out, you know, starting out, you know, people were just building text fields everywhere, right? They didn't even know really what screw number fields, you know, like we could do everything in text fields. And there was no automation systems back then. And so we started looking at, let's start streamlining these things. So the way that we take Iris is we'll pull in a brand new organization that has come to us, and we'll take a snapshot, basically back up their entire org. And then we can load Iris up and we can see the connectivity of basically how their brain looks right now. Iris is like the brain of your organization. And we can see how all of your data connects together and where it flows through the system. So, and when we then start to revamp and restructure your entire organization, you end up with a system that is highly connected and fluid and communicates with all other pieces of data within your system. So you are able to see it as a now an interconnected brain of circuitry of how the system works together. So when we look at it and we're doing this first assessment, we say, well, look, you've got five different workspaces here that aren't connected to anything else. And you're talking about supply chain issues. Let's actually consult about how we can bring these processes in together and start connecting the data together. So it started out as really just a consulting to get an insight really quick for us of what can we do to help this customer be able to work faster and more efficiently. And Iris was that answer.
I've not had much of an experiment with it, but I think I'm fascinated to continue to see where, you know, where Sync continues to allow the externalization and manipulation of data. I mean, I think that's going to be a really interesting thing. And I agree, you know, when you say, you know, the change from the even just the name, the backup for Podio versus Sync, it does make a great deal of sense in that for that. What do you find? I mean, right now, from a Sync point of view, if I'm a lay person and I just kind of I'm just getting into this, chances are I may not be able to dive straight into like capabilities, right? Mm-hmm. I may not have that quite that much, but what do you see as the first good steps from a Sync point of view?
Yeah, so the first steps are just going to be coming in and securing the data by backing up, coming in, logging in, and backing up your org. And right now it's completely free because we're revamping everything. It's our pricing is going to be $1 a day for one org, and then let's say $1.50 a day for files. To include files for an organization. So it's not going to be horribly cheap or horribly expensive. Sorry. But as we get into, just backing up the data, boom, that's all you have to do. It's secure and log in, once a month or, to make sure your access credentials don't, your Podio API credentials don't fail on us. But all of your data is going to be backed up nonstop and you're good to go off the races. But if you want to get more into, let's say I want to build a custom portal and I want to feed data into it, if you want to do data science and data management, or if you want to do really anything more about leveraging that data or gaining access to a data lake or us building a data lake for you from, 15 or 20 different connected platforms, that's just taking a phone call and then building your strategy and saying, okay, let's this is how we're going to put it together. And then setting up the plan and making sure that we're helping you get that in place. There's been a couple of companies that have done it before on other systems. They actually were using MongoDB themselves, but they came to us and said, look, you've got all the connections to the platforms through Ava. You've got all the ability and know-how. Can we just have you build all this for us and then, create these aggregation pipelines out to systems? And the answer is absolutely, yeah, that's what we're really here for, to help leverage it, to help customers get what they need done.
And how do people, obviously we're going to put the links into the podcast page, podcast description. How do people go out and find this? How do people get started? You said it was free to get going right now. The pricing is going to come into it. How do people get started? Where do they go?
thatapp.io. So sync.thatapp.io, and pretty ambiguous name, but it's print.thatapp.io, ava.thatapp.io. So it's just thatapp.io, and you can authorize with your Podio and you can kick off with print, sync, or Ava.
Excellent. Well, Seth, thanks so much for coming on. I'm going to put the link to all of the products down on the page so people can have a one-click to them. Although, of course, you can just go to thatapp.io. I do encourage everyone to take a look at it. Go head over and connect your Podio and see what it can do, because it really is pretty amazing and pretty impressive. And you know, the ability to actually see some of the data and manipulate it in that way is if you are more developer inclined, I think it opens up a huge amount of capabilities.
Yeah, I really do. Yeah, thank you so much for having me.
All right. Well, thanks very much, Seth, and have a great week.
You've been listening to Supercharged with Jordan Samuel Fleming. Subscribe today on iTunes, Google Play, or Spotify for your weekly dive into how you can supercharge your business by making it powered by Podio. Be sure to check out our website, wearegamechangers.com, where you can learn more and arrange a 30-minute call with Jordan to help you understand how Podio supercharges you.